watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Happy March, everybody! We're back! Happy March!
Happy March! Happy March.
Cheers. Cheers!
It doesn't really feel like
Cheers.
March. Because
I know.
So
we've been drinking beer,
so
like Guinness
snow
or something.
On the ground still, yes.
I know. Should have brought the Guinness.
I know. Next time.
Right. We shut up. You didn't bring it.
You brought that shirt,
but you look like a leprechaun.
You brought that shirt.
All right. I look good for March.
That's got the Irish cap on. I love it.
I mean, it doesn't really feel like spring. I mean, we brought the daffodils because we're...
We want spring to come.
Spring will be here this month.
It's getting closer.
I'm done with school delays. There cannot be any more school delays or school cancellations.
I could still take one or two.
I mean, it's good to sleep
in. That's right. Because
I
want a delay.
Yeah. Needs to get to work.
So did you guys see the article that we posted on our Facebook page and about drinking?
I felt so good about myself after you posted that, Adriana.
I know. But you exercise.
Like, and then I went home and drank wine, so I felt terrible.
Better that we don't exercise.
So tell everybody.
Yeah, so I printed it out, and it was the HuffPost UK edition. Talks about one glass of red wine, if you don't exercise, it has similar benefits as to resveratrol, which is a compound found in red wine. It's similar to people who, similar to when you exercise.
That's right. The hormone
so,
that comes
yes,
out.
It improves physical performance, heart function, and muscle strength, the same way as if you go work out in a gym.
Oh my gosh.
Right.
So I'm like, so we're already improving ourselves by
drinking.
Every time we
it
have.
It also keeps your sugar levels balanced.
In addition to the whole heart thing you knew about
heart health,
the red
wine. Yes.
It's like a workout.
Absolutely.
So and drink up, everybody.
Right, so drink. You know, we already knew it helps with preventing like some cancer and dementia and everything.
Not my
so
case,
now,
but everyone else's case, yeah.
Right, but you know, you're special.
Small.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, no, I'm all for it.
So I was like, then why am I even going to work out? I can just
it's a double workout.
And
it
also
and the workout from the
yep,
true,
and you can true. Have blueberries, peanut butter, red grapes, and dark chocolate also. Helps your intake of resveratrol also. So
nice. The dark chocolate with the red wine.
I thought that was a nice little story.
So don't feel guilty about all the candy you got for Valentine's Day. You can
get
the chocolate, eat it, no problem.
Not all of us went away like you did.
No.
Oh.
It was very
quick.
Oh gosh.
By the fire.
And martinis. Now, you had martinis. I saw pictures of martinis.
I did. Well, actually, John posted the martinis.
See, he's a romantic, that John.
John Verrentia.
He's gonna love watching.
It's three olive martini.
Yep. Well, soon we're gonna have martinis in Cammie's new kitchen, which is almost.
I'm living at Mainlow's right now, which is lovely because they're lovely people, right. And they serve me wine, but
and food.
I want to get back to my house soon.
I can't wait to see your new kitchen. Are you so excited?
So excited! I bought a chandelier. It's gonna be like farm style chic. Farm style meets chic. You know that new.
Because you knocked down the wall between the dining
rooms. Oh my gosh! And our
you and the dogs are
Dynamo,
and your mother-in-law
he's amazing.
Oh my gosh! Everybody
and
the
kids.
The kids. Yeah,
that's nice though. They don't mind.
Oh, there's our
that's
favorite
the
thing.
Okay.
Oh, let me get my little favorite thing here. I guess
all
I'm
right.
going first
Lori's
again.
Go first.
I love
her
yet
right.
again. This is like I love it. Lori starts it. I love it.
Thank you, Cam.
Keep the tradition.
All right, this is very simple. It's not very. I mean, it's my favorite
So we're doing
thing,
our favorite
yeah,
things
our favorite
for the month
for the
of March.
Month. Right, so we all choose one thing that we would like to share with everybody. And mine is tea.
Very Irish.
Any tea. Yeah, it's very Irish. So I usually have this either in the morning or in the afternoon. This is my Starbucks mug. But yeah, this is green tea. Or I love my new vanilla chai that my girlfriend got
so
me.
So this is just decor for the camera.
Yeah, that's
just,
yes, of course.
Highlighting
it's
the tape.
It's taped time.
Okay. It's taped. And then, of course, I have to have a little snack. And this is so good.
So you have two favorite things.
So
I
but it goes along with this, right?
Okay, it's your snack
so,
time.
So yeah, I have a little snack. When the kids have a snack, I have a snack. my students. So it's an organic honey oat bar, and it's made from Nature's Bakery, and it's dairy-free, cholesterol-free,
sounds so yummy.
Low sodium, and low sugar, and it's so good.
Adrian goes,
It's very light. It's not chocolate, but it is good, and they sell it at Costco, and it's only got 90 calories for both little bars. So it's my special little indulgence.
So are you opening this up for us, or what's happening?
What's happening right
Let's
now?
Let's open it and try it.
Okay,
and
while you open it, who's going to go next?
All right,
Mario,
go ahead.
Mario, you go. What are you going to have?
Right.
Yes, tell us about your favorite
thing. I got
two
of these things. This is brand new.
Whoa.
I'm using.
Is that underwear? Are you wearing it?
No, it's not.
Oh, it's green
Bluetooth
underwear.
It's wireless.
Oh, okay.
I use it for exercise when I run, and it's great.
Nice.
And it's green.
Yeah, and I got a Groupon. It was like, buy one.
Thank
like
you. Can we give it to Carol?
Or buy
Thank
two
you.
For 20
So you
bucks,
exercise
nice.
With this on.
Thank you.
And it's a wireless.
Yeah,
that's perfect.
It's all Bluetooth. It's all wireless. Yeah, great.
We got to get those girls.
Yeah.
All right.
And did you have something else?
That was it.
That was it. That's awesome.
Nice. So all wait, right, we need comments on the
We
bar.
Like it.
Delicious.
It is good.
It is good, right?
I have to buy this by my nutritionist.
It's a dairy, but it's a low sugar, so
I have to
buy this.
My nutritionist has to.
And yours is a good segue in, because now that I have this in my teeth.
All right, yes.
This is all over my teeth.
Yeah, Carol.
Right, so my favorite thing this month, it's a VO Life, it's a toothbrush sanitizer.
Oh.
This one is my son's.
Because she's a germaphobe.
So I am.
I'm a germaphobe. She needs that.
And so many times my kids leave their toothbrush in bathrooms
like
are so dirty. It is a ninja. This is my son's.
Oh, it's heavy.
But they come in a variety of colors. They come in plain. They come in, my daughter's is a penguin. Mm-hmm. So when I saw the kids leaving their toothbrushes like all over the sink and all over just randomly on the side and over on the brushes, it was
together.
Awful. Yeah, no.
I know.
So all you do, it's 6 minutes. You put your toothbrush in, it's different sizes. You press the little button and it will do the ultraviolet light, cleans the toothbrush head. Supposedly it's 99.9%. Gets rid of all of the germs, the bacteria, the salmonella, E. coli, whatever random things are in a bathroom.
You have salmonella on your toothbrush.
Well, hopefully not, but these are the things that it's
supposed
to
be cleaning.
So get your
toothbrush.
Sorry.
And
it takes 6 minutes, and then it shuts off by itself. It's battery operated, which are great to take to travel, so they're not like bouncing around in your suitcase.
So you even
take
them on your trips?
So you can fit how many
of them? Not these, the little
Are you kidding me? You take this thing on
the... Not that. That's at home. No,
but this
but
can
the
fit
last
one toothbrush.
One toothbrush.
One toothbrush.
Yep.
But love it. Okay.
All right.
Nice.
Well, I'll go next. That's very lovely. Mine has nothing to do. Well, mine is actually about organizing.
I'll have 5 seconds at the end.
Mine is, I'll go really fast. Mine is about organizing because I'm an organizing freak.
Yes.
And I found this great app. It's called Cozy, C-O-Z-I, and I've been using it for a couple years now.
The best.
You can find it on your phone. I'll put it up on the screen.
Yeah.
And it is great for families because everyone has a different color. I can input the girls' things. I can input if David has a late work night. David can access it from his phone. Gabrielle can access it. And it also allows you to put other things like shopping lists, to-do lists, recipes. You can also print it out. And I usually print out the weekly schedule. Did I bring a copy of me? I usually print out the weekly schedule and put it on the refrigerator because even though I have the big everyone's always like, what are we eating?
Oh, my gosh.
Because when we go to Adria's, if you can't touch her calendar on the fridge.
No, because, you know.
But it has dinners for the next month.
Yes.
Oh, no. I mean,
no, for a week. For a week.
For a week? Okay, for a week.
But what's nice about it is because David will say, what are we doing?
And that's the best thing for David.
March 17th.
Because he has no idea what all you ladies have planned and he can just look on his phone.
Yeah.
He just knows where he needs to go.
But you have to look. So it's free. It's a free app.
I love it.
For $19.99, you can upgrade. I don't have the upgrade one, but you can.
So this is just
a
free one.
And I think the upgrade just gives you no ads, and you get reminders about stuff.
Right.
But birthday tracker, but, you know.
Great. I
so that's my favorite thing. I love Cozy.
Yeah, that's really neat.
Cammie, what's yours? Okay, so keeping with the Irish theme, my new love, well, I brought the little mini, I have a bigger one, and I have shower gel, but this is made in Ireland, and it's a hand cream. I just realized now, before we went on set, how do you pronounce this? I think it's Inish is the proper way, and it means island.
Oh, it smells pretty. I can smell it from
I'm
here.
I'm sorry. You guys can smell it. And then I got a little.
Oh, can we try a little bit?
It's very clean. It's made in Ireland.
Oh, my gosh. I love this.
It's wonderful.
I smelled it. We were in RJ Julia, and they have like a little bookstore. They have like a little store attached to RJ Julia, and we saw this. And
that's nice.
I feel like it's even made local. Maybe it's not made locally.
Ireland, made in Ireland.
Oh. Do you want to try some? We didn't let you try any. Would you like?
Catch.
It smells good from here.
Should I throw it?
No.
Okay. No, I will. So Cammy's gonna take us out of here.
I'm gonna take you out of here. Okay. Oh, yeah. So coming up next, we have some fabulous guests in store. Quite a few. Three.
Yes. Three guests tonight. It's our biggest show.
Biggest show. Yeah. And these so ladies excited. Are fantastic. We're lucky to have them. Just you wait.
Excited to talk to them about all their adventures.
Yes.
All right, so welcome back, and we're thrilled to have three mompreneurs here, and they're joining us tonight to talk about why they started their own companies, how they did it, and how they manage everything else that's involved in, you know, in their lives. I'm happy to introduce our three guests tonight. The first one is Jane Schock. She's owner of Iris Photography in West Hartford. Dr. Melissa Lambright, owner of Sight. She's an optometrist here in town. And Marina Lori Clark, owner and creative director of Marina Looney Lori, sorry, Events. Welcome, ladies.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Healthy. So you're exercising while you're sitting there. You're getting the benefits of exercise. Yes. So thank you so much, first of all, for being here. It's a show I've wanted to do for a very long time, Mompreneurs, and I thought I would just start off by. Did you know that Wikipedia actually has a definition for what a mompreneur is?
And who knew that's a real thing?
It's a real thing. It's a female business owner who are actively balancing the role of mom and the role of entrepreneur. So basically you're just like rock star mom, really.
In our rock star town. Yes.
And I thought we'd start with Jane, and we'll ask, I was just going to, like, how did you start your business? Like, how did it all come about? Because you have an amazing photography business now. That your husband works with you, for you?
We
love you, Mike.
He joined in 2008 full time, but probably, I want to say, because Sevi's 13, so 15 or 16 years ago, I was working in the corporate world, automotive in Detroit, and knew I didn't want to do that for the rest of my life, but wasn't sure what I wanted to do, and Mike and I went on a safari. And I started photographing, and I thought, maybe this is it. And I went back, and I just took like a leisure services kind of class, and that led to 2 years of night school and quitting my job and starting the business out in Detroit. And then we moved to West Hartford about a year later, and I started it from here then. And it's just grown, and from Mike calling it a hobby to him coming to work with us. So it's been great. It's a completely different lifestyle. And
how many children do you have?
I have two boys, 11 and 13, Sebi and Jude at Bugby and KP.
So what started as a hobby really is your and Mike's, this is your livelihood now. I mean,
absolutely, yeah.
Proof that you can turn a hobby into.
It's true.
And you're very successful. I mean, Jane, you were in every single magazine.
Yes. Everybody
knows the
name.
Oh, definitely.
Adorable studio right on LaSalle.
We're going to have new headshots. Jane's going to give us new headshots.
Oh, yay. Yes.
Well, thanks. It's just such a transition, too, from both of you going like corporate art, photography. Were you interested in like photography, artsy?
I feel like I went into marketing because I had something creative in me to do. So I was in marketing, but that, I feel like the higher up I got in the corporate world, it got less creative and more very businessy and very pricing and negotiating and a lot of that. And, but I never did photography, but my dad did a lot of like 8mm movies and was always photographing something. So I think maybe that was in the back of my mind.
Now, do you involve the boys at all, Jane, in the business?
I do.
Like free labor, right?
They are not. We actually pay them to model.
There's beautiful pictures you have of the whole family on your website, too.
All right, thank you. Yeah, they're not like full force in.
That's
like,
great.
But they modeled for when you did our.
They did model when we did the site website.
Snowstorm, we had all these models set up, and then that is no one could get to us. And so, just like I asked you boys that are, I know, how to get them.
Exactly.
I mean, that was such a brave and risky thing to do because you're changing your life. I mean, you're leaving the corporate world to see if you can make it as a...
You know, it didn't feel brave at the time. It felt like I had to do it. Like, it felt... I felt like this job in this life is not me in the corporate world. Like, it was so strong. I knew I had to find something. And when I found photography, it was like, it was so strong that this is it. So
That is awesome.
It didn't feel scary at all, even though obviously I was going from a corporate income to nothing.
Right.
And then starting at zero and building it up. But
well, bravo to you.
Yes, bravo to you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
it's
a
great
story.
You guys have a crew or just you and your crew?
We use freelance crews, so depending on the job. And Mike and I, we're lucky working together that we're interested in very different things. So I'm the lead on some parts of the business, he's the lead on others. Sometimes we would be assisting each other, but sometimes we bring in freelance crews depending on the job. And certainly when we split up on days to shoot, we do use freelance.
Yeah. When it comes to weddings and stuff, or special events,
yeah.
What do you guys prefer from a DJ point?
What do you mean, what do I prefer?
For example, when I do a wedding,
I prefer a man in a
oh, no, I
St. Patrick's Day
no,
t-shirt.
No. When I do a wedding, I have like an outline, what's got to go on.
Yeah.
And I gave an outline to you, to anybody, like whoever's the whole
thing. We work with both bands and DJs, and we like someone who's open and friendly. And I'm sure you guys like the same thing. We work with each other. We have to communicate during an event so that we don't miss the shot. We rely a lot on the DJ.
Well, that's why I give that. I always give it
to that's very
helpful.
See,
you can give her their name out now.
And vice versa. So.
And Melissa, let's get to you because you are amazing and your business right here in town. Can we call you Melissa or should we call you Dr.
Dr. Melissa. We know Melissa. We're patients of Dr. Melissa.
That's right.
So all about the question I had, what are some of the challenges you face in your business? Or tell us a little bit at first about the business.
Yeah. So about 10 years ago, I opened Sight, which was really fun. And again, not scary in that, I'm married now. At the time I was married, I'm still married. But he had a job full time. And so I was able to develop my dream practice without having to worry, like if you were a single person and then wanting to open up your own business. So to have that
little
sort
bit of
support and
security
was awesome.
Were you working for another practice and you said, I just want to run my own?
Yeah, you know, and I had worked in some different centers and learned a lot and saw some different things. I worked at the VA hospital for a while as a clinical instructor, worked in some private practices, and that was really neat because then I got to see what do I want my practice to look like, and then what are things where I'm like, ooh.
What don't I want my practice to look like?
And I think, you know, and so we opened up Sight, and it's been incredible. And then about 3 years ago, we developed the Sight Sensory Rehabilitation Center, and that's grown into having occupational therapy as well as vision therapy. We do a lot of, work with patients that have had a concussion or a TBI and lost visual function, like teaming and focusing. And then we also do a lot of work with developmental patients that didn't develop proper function. I also spend one Friday a month at the Jengra Center, so I work a lot with their OT and PT and help provide any sort of recommendations, modifications, or treatment for kids there. So
the Jengra School.
You don't
primarily focus on children. Your practice is children and adults?
Yeah, so we have a peds clinic. We have a children's clinic. Yep. And then we also, of course, have our adult clinic, which we've always had. And I did a residency in disease and am board certified. So we also do a lot of disease management with adults and kids as well.
And you have children.
Yes.
Your
how
mommy.
Do you juggle all of that?
How old are you?
Tell us about your kids. I have two girls. They're 4 and 7, Kate and Charlotte.
Wow.
And
so very busy, very
active. So you need cozy. You need the cozy.
Yes, the new app.
For us, one of my friends introduced me to the world of au pairs, and that's been awesome for our family.
Great.
There's just this cultural exchange, and I always say you sort of get back what you give, and we've been really blessed to have some amazing women, girls come into our house, and So that's been really
helpful. So they're there when you can't.
They live with us, and so I've never had to, you know, get the girls up and get them dressed and feed them breakfast.
That's right.
You know, I get to have breakfast with them and get dressed with them. They run in my bathroom when I'm getting ready. And they're like, I'm going to brush my teeth too, but I don't have to like direct them. And so to have that support system is huge.
So that's probably a big tip you would give people then, have a support
system. As a mom, get on
get an au pair.
The au pair have a support system.
Right? Yeah, that's huge. You can't do it on your own.
Right.
You need a team.
Right. Exactly.
And two, we're blessed, I mean, with great friends and really a village around us. So that's been really helpful too.
And your office is located on Main Street?
On Main Street.
Yep. Like right next to Sweet Frog, I want to say.
Yeah, we're just a couple down from Sweet Frog,
right,
or next to Play It Again. Everyone always knows Play It
Again. Oh, yeah.
I was telling you earlier. I was telling Melissa earlier. My mother went there recently. We all pitched in and got our glasses, and she did the. She just raved about your place.
Yeah,
that is really
it really
nice
is
frames.
Amazing, and it's all redone. Your whole.
We did do a little 10-year anniversary remodel, which was fun. Just to.
So you've been in town for 10 years now.
Yeah. I can't believe that. That's just crazy. Mm-hmm.
That's very.
Yeah.
Well, cheers to you.
Cheers to you.
Okay, and next we have Marina. Welcome.
Thank you.
And why don't you tell us a little bit about your...
My business?
Yeah, your business.
So I have a company that plans and designs and produces events, and we do everything from nonprofit to corporate work to private parties. And I fell into the business because I was in PR previously in New York City, and I was in fashion industry, so... I was producing fashion shows and parties for fashion clients, and then when we moved up to West Hartford, that kind of fell by the wayside, and I kept the business events going. And so I don't do anything half as serious as Dr. Melissa. I just parties.
Parties are serious. I do planning at work, and it is a lot of work.
A lot of work.
And I'm so glamorous and fun.
I was going to say that passed. Wow.
And you have two little boys, right?
I do have two little boys, Santi, who is 7, almost 8, and Giacomo, who just turned 9. Wow. And I am in the business of making people happy.
Which is always nice.
Really great. And we just recently started working with the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Lovely.
We're going to be throwing parties for people who, you know, wish for
that's so nice.
Yeah.
So Marina, would you encourage other moms to do the same thing? Start, you know,
Because you started it from the ground up.
Yeah. Well, I started before I had children, so.
Right, so you had that business already established
different.
Before.
I mean, it's very intense, it's on weekends, it's nighttime, so I don't know that it's the ideal job for a mom. But I definitely encourage moms to start businesses because, you know, it just gives you a sense of self, and you can explore your passions, and you know, you definitely need a village to keep it all going, but the reward is fantastic, and I think it's important for girls and boys to see their moms working and you know, doing things and not always relying on them to be around, and just also helps them be more independent.
Right,
so.
Absolutely.
I think part of the reason we started the show was because we wanted to show that we're all four working moms who live in town, and we juggle. There's a lot of juggling. And I buy cupcakes now. I mean,
she puts them on a pretty platter.
No, but I mean, but you saw
that.
It's
But I think,
like you said, it's important for our children to see that we are working moms and we're trying to make it.
Yep.
We're balancing. Some days we're giving 150%. Sometimes we're giving 100%. Sometimes we're screaming at the top of our lungs.
I try not to do
that.
But she used a very calm
I try to stay calm under pressure, because if you see your clients screaming, that's not a good thing.
Right.
And your kids, I think, also sense that when you're screaming. I mean, listen, we're all human and we make mistakes, and I admit that to my kids, but I will say my one tip to impart is that if you're with your kids, you're with your kids, and if you're working, you're working.
Right.
And if you try and juggle both, it's, for me at least, it's a toxic mix.
I agree.
Right.
You're very right.
I carve out my time for each.
Right. So what would you say some of the challenges are that you ladies face? I mean, of course we know the juggling, but is there something, one thing in particular that you could share that, like, have you had an experience that you had to make a choice between, I don't know, I mean, I think it would be really hard. Your business depends on you,
right?
Right? There's
You're
not
running
somebody
your
else that can fill in for Dr. Melissa or go to a wedding or go to a bat mitzvah, you know.
Yeah.
If you're,
yeah, I think for me, it's maybe for you too, Marina, it's the weekend, for me, is the issue.
It's a hard
because
part.
I love shooting weddings. I love shooting families that are mostly available on the weekends.
Yeah, right.
But I love being with my kids on the weekends. And now, as they get older, they're pretty busy during
They've
the week as
events.
Well.
Right.
So that's when we can hang out together. So. Right. For me, I did make a decision to kind of back off weddings a bit, and Mike is now the lead on weddings, and we just did that very easily with the price difference, and that's been a great thing for me now. So, and I feel like even if I'm shooting families on the weekend, it's an hour, and I'm 5 minutes from home. I'm not in Fairfield County.
You choose the ones that you...
And I try, the other thing I really try to do is schedule, even during the week I try to do it, that schedule similar tasks on the same day. So if it's a shooting day, it's a shooting day. Or if it's a marketing day, it's a marketing day. Mm. Versus, I think when I started
stay
doing...
Focused.
Stay focused. Versus when I think I started doing family portraits more, I was kind of taking one whenever other people were available. And headshots, I was taking like one on Tuesday and one on Friday.
Whenever
but
they
we have
do
to
it.
Set
Particular
up.
Day that so, you do headshots.
Yeah, so that's been very, very helpful to streamline the business.
Nice. And what about like as far as women goes, I know that I heard something like just heard it in the past about women, like minority owned, like the state of Connecticut promoting, helping minority owned businesses for women. Did you guys find any help? For people who are listening who might want to start their own business who are women.
Like a
Did
tax
you know
break,
about any
I feel
this?
Like.
Yeah, there's something with minority owned for women, some kind of benefit.
I started
to them.
My business 10 years ago, and I haven't recently looked into that. So
we have the forms actually half filled out.
And
I think it's, I don't know if it's
there,
a
right?
tax, I hadn't heard that there's a tax benefit, but I think you can get, especially
Grants
if you're working with corporations, they have. Quotas they need of certain number of minority or women-owned businesses.
Yep.
So I think it can be very helpful if you're working, trying to get corporate business.
Right. That's what I heard, and I just didn't know how it worked, and I didn't know if, you know, I know that there's that out there for people to kind of look into and take advantage of as a woman.
Yeah.
I'm leaving with a tip.
And you're leaving with a gift too, because we always forget to give our guests a gift.
It's a gift, Adria.
So we didn't wrap them really pretty, but we have to leave you with some exercising tips.
When you're stressed out running your business,
this is last
thing.
And this is just to say thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you.
And maybe what we'll do is if you all have some tips and suggestions for women who want to start their own business.
Absolutely, because you know there are women out there who are thinking about it.
Yeah.
Just don't know how to make that move.
Or like supports that can help them.
And your experience is so varied. I mean, there's a lot of variety in everything you guys have said and in your own personal experiences and professional experiences.
We can share it on our social media.
Right.
Yeah.
Great.
Page.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
Wow.
Oh my God.
That's great.
Those ladies,
Those ladies are amazing.
How do they do it all?
I know. We think we juggle a lot. They're running their own businesses.
Yeah, I know.
I mean,
so motivating. Like,
they deserve every wine that we give them.
Smart ladies.
They deserve a lot of wine.
Every glass of wine that they have.
Absolutely.
No, we're going to, I love promoting, I love talking about women who run their own businesses. I just think we need to be doing more women need to lift each other up.
Absolutely.
We need to do more of this.
Support each other.
That's right.
Yeah, we should have like I don't know, a happy hour party where we just all just.
Okay.
All right.
Let's do it.
With red wine.
Red wine. Yep.
Yeah. But we're excited about our topic next month, too. We should kind of, we can give a little teaser for our April show.
So it's going to be all about mindfulness, and we're hoping to secure a top-notch expert in that area.
All taking care of ourselves,
and again,
right?
Mindfulness, a little bit of peace in our lives.
And it's all about mind over matter, honestly, dealing with health issues,
stress.
Through it, stress.
Balancing
helps
all.
Everything.
Yep. So we're excited. We
have
a great
very
show. Yes. Happy spring, everyone. Make sure you look at our Facebook page. We'll have all the products that we talked about tonight on our Facebook page.
And
where we can reach these fabulous women, how you can hire
their
them.
Their sites, their information,
yep,
all their contact
absolutely.
Information will be on there.
Yeah.
So don't forget to like our page. Mario. If you haven't, yeah, yeah, like our page.
Who doesn't like our page?
I know.
We're working on our website.
There might be someone out there that doesn't.
Yes.
And don't forget, everybody, you take the time in.
Don't forget to take the time out.
What's the place where you go every night and you snuggle up real tight? Is it in front of your screen where everything we show is exactly how it seems? Everything we show is right for you. Everything we show is true, true, true. So get your drink and give us a wink, 'cause what you're watching is Mom's Time Out.